Hello everybody, this is Volkans, and today we are talking about diorama building. As shown in my previous video, I assembled the Tallneck LEGO set and it felt like it was screaming for a nice environment. So my wife and I decided to build a diorama around it. First we listed all the details that we wanted to achieve, then of course the constraints that come with those details. Here is what we came up with.
The idea was to create Red Rock Mountain as the background, with a night sky. Now, the difficulty is that the space is limited. Height and width are less of an issue, but depth is. So we have to plan the mountain steepness precisely. The whole set should be protected from dust, so it needs a front cover. It should also have some illumination that is activated by a motion sensor. And to make it more complicated, I wanted to include a sensor for environment light, so that the lighting is only activated at dusk or at night. To make it even more complicated, I wanted to change the moon phase after each activation. It soon became clear that I need a microcontroller to run the whole thing. And finally, the circuit should be battery operated. I had an unused 12-volt battery for a while and wanted to use 12-volt LED strips anyway.
Now this is a ton of stuff to do, and it took several months to finish it because we could only work on it in our free time. Also, the topics can be clearly divided into two categories: building the diorama and creating the electronics. This video is about the diorama. Let's start!
For the backplate, I chose 4mm plywood. The base plate will be made of 6mm plywood. It is important that it is about 1.5 cm shorter than the actual depth of the shelf. This is necessary, as the front frame will also penetrate into the shelf a bit. To change the moon phases, I plan to use a small stepper motor. Due to the dimensions of the motor, 3 cm spacing between the wall and the backplate is required. This will provide also room for the control circuit. The backplate should be removable for several reasons, so next I cut out 2 MDF blocks. These will be fixed to the base plate and hold the backplate. Later, the mountains will cover them, so they will not be visible, but this also means they cannot be as tall as the mountains. The depth of the battery is more than 3 cm, so it is necessary to make a cutout in the backplate. I decided to create a complete battery compartment. This again will be covered by the mountains. To connect the circuit and the front cover, a flat cable will be used. This cable will run on the base plate, but under the diorama, so it must be placed before creating the terrain. And it also needs a cutout in the back plate. We carefully decided the placement of the LEGO set and drew the contour onto the base plate to cut it out. Of course, we could have placed the set onto the base plate and built a terrain around it, but unfortunately the vertical spacing above the set is limited in the shaft, so we decided that even those 6mm count. With every part cut out, it was time to assemble the structure. Next, we fix the flat cable.
With that, the base structure was complete, so finally we can get to work on the terrain. As I mentioned before, this is our first diorama ever. So before starting, we watched some YouTube videos about how to do it. I mean, like, a lot of videos. And as it turned out, we learned many useful practices.
I bought a single 20mm thick XPS plate. First, I cut it into 38cm wide strips. That will be the width of the diorama. We cut out the contours of the individual layers in the mountain with a hot knife. XPS emits really bad fumes when heated, so this should be done outdoors or at least in a well-ventilated area. Note that we also cut out the corners where the mountain touches the backplate support. Just to see where we are, I built up the mountain temporarily. The bottom layer needs a cutout where the flat cable will run. I had some styrofoam ceiling cover left over, so we used that for the flat area around the Lego. I glued the layers using construction glue. As you can see, we drafted up the rough mountain contour onto the backplate and also marked the position where the moon will be located. Next, I glued down the horizontal part. We started to refine the rock contours with a hot wire cutter. I did some more work with the utility knife and did some more. This is the part where the result keeps getting better and better, so the more effort you put into it, the more realistic it will look. We mixed up some plaster and applied it with our hands to the mountain. At some points, we corrected it with a paintbrush. If you compare our model with actual photos, it does not look bad at all. But of course, it still needs to be painted and must get some plants as well. We used acrylic paints. First, we mixed the base color. Now, you should always prepare it in larger quantity than necessary, as you may need some for minor corrections later. You will see we also had this case. We also added some wallpaper glue to the paint. This will make it harder and also create a more water-resistant cover. Painting took longer than expected, but it was satisfying to watch the progression. I After completing the mountain, we also painted the base. Next, we mixed the brown wash, which turned out to be way too thick. Eventually we got it right, and the rock started to look realistic. We continued with adding some highlights, and did also some dry brushing. That added more to the realism, so at one point we decided to call it a day. Now, this looks really nice. Next, I glued the mountain into place. It was after this when I realized I don't like the bottom. It would look much better if there was a slope at the foot of the mountain covered with gravel, like in this photo. I cut out the slope pieces from leftover XPS parts. I used hot glue to quickly fix the pieces into position. To make the slope melt into the mountain, I mixed some plaster and applied it. Note that there should be no rocks here, as the gravel consists of small stones that travel downward. Accordingly, I created some crevices from top to bottom. I used some actual gravel that was once in our aquarium. First I screened it so that I have really small pieces only. I diluted some PVA glue with water to fix the gravel to the slope. Before I applied the glue, I aligned the diorama so that the slopes are horizontal. This way the glue won't run off, and neither will the gravel pieces. After scattering the gravel to the surface, I applied additional glue to make it more stable, but unfortunately I don't have a footage about that. Luckily, I had some leftover paint with the original color. After painting the base color, I also added some brown wash to the gravel, but very lightly. So now our mountain is finished, we can start adding the plants. We don't have any of those fancy electrostatic machines that professionals use to create realistic grass, and as beginners, we didn't want to buy one either. The result is of course less perfect, but we can live with that. We added grass especially into the crevices, as those are the places where it grows in most cases. To fix the grass, we used PVA glue. As the final step, we added some bushes. Originally I planned to add trees as well, but it would have made the whole diorama way too crowded.
With this, the terrain part of the diorama was complete. Although it was our first attempt, we are really satisfied with the result. So the story will continue with the electronics part, and that video will come in a few weeks. Until then, happy crafting and see you soon!